morning students. Today we are going to learn work done for a Francis turbine, velocity triangle of a Kaplan turbine and work done by a Kaplan turbine. So here you can see work done for a Francis turbine. So work done by the water or the runner per second is given by rho into Q into VW1 into U1. You know the general formula for work done by the water or the runner per second is given as rho into Q into VW1 into U1 plus minus VW2 into U2. Since in case of Francis turbine, your VW2 equal to 0, so this total terms become 0 and work done for Francis turbine is given as rho Q into VW1 into U1. Next is your work done per second per weight of water striking per second. So here also in case the VW2 is 0, so we get 1 by G VW1 into U1. Next is your hydraulic efficiency. Hydraulic efficiency is nothing but the runner power and what divided by your water power. So what is the runner power? Here you can see rho into Q in VW1 into U1 divided by 1000, and water power is nothing but your rho GH. So rho into Q into MGH, you can, in terms of that you can write down rho into Q GH. So this get cancelled and this terms get cancelled. So what we are getting, hydraulic efficiency equal to VW1 into U1 divided by GH. So now here you can see some of the important relation for Francis turbine which will help you to solve the problems for Francis turbine. So first point is the width ratio, that is denoted by N. So that is nothing but ratio of the width of wheel divided by your diameter. So this one is nothing but B1 by D1. So this one, where this value varies from 0.1 to 0.4. If it is given in the question, you can take the width ratio or find the diameter from the width ratio, or if not given, you have to take the value between 0.1 to 0.4. Next is your flow ratio. So flow ratio is nothing but VF, that is your velocity of flow, divided by root over of 2GH. This value varies from 0.15 to 0.3. Next is your the speed ratio. That speed ratio is nothing but U1 by root over of 2GH. This varies from 0.6 to 0.9. Next is your, this is a model of a Kaplan turbine. So what is a Kaplan turbine is nothing but axial flow reaction turbine. So what is an axial flow turbine? If the water flows through the runner along the direction parallel to the axis of rotation of the runner, the turbine is known as axial flow turbine. And reaction turbine, you all of you know that the turbine in which pressure energy as well as kinetic energy is available, that is a reaction turbine. So this is the model of a Kaplan turbine. It consists of a shaft. This one is your shaft. This portion is your hub and this is the runner vane. So what happens, water enters to the scroll casing. Scroll casing is here it is mentioned, which is not available. Scroll casing is here in this position, and water enters from the scroll casing towards the guide vanes. Then guide vanes guides the water to the runner vanes, and this runner vanes indeed rotate the hub and the shaft start rotating. So the turbine starts rotating and indirectly it is moving the shaft, and the water moves downwards towards the draft tube towards your tail race. So this is how the working of a Kaplan turbine is done. Next we will see the work done in a Kaplan turbine. So this is the diagram of a Kaplan turbine. It consists of scroll casings. Here I have drawn the scroll casing and this is the guide vanes. So from here the water enters towards the guide vanes, and this guide vanes guide the water to the runner, and this is your hub. So water enters through this runner vanes and it rotates the shaft like this, and next the water gets collected through this draft tube and it goes towards the tail race. So here discharge, that is Q, is nothing but pi by 4 d 0 by dB. So what is DO by dB? DO is nothing but the outer diameter of runner, this one, and dB is nothing but diameter of hub, and VF is nothing but velocity of flow at inlet. Next, this there are some of important terms related your Kaplan turbine. So the peripheral velocity, that is your velocity at inlet at and outlet, that means u1 is equal to u2, that equals to pi d0 do into n divided by 60. Next, here velocity of flow at inlet is equal to velocity of flow at outlet. Next, area of flow at inlet is equal to area of flow at outlet. Pause. So this is nothing equal nothing but pi by 4 do square minus your dB square. So Kaplan turbine, the name Kaplan is given by V. Kaplan, an Australian engineer, and this type of turbine is seen where large quantity of water is required at low head. Thank you. So this is the velocity triangle for a Kaplan turbine. So already, as I have explained, this one is your V1, and V1 is making an vertical component, Vf1, that is your velocity of flow, and Vw1, that is your horizontal component, that is your what? Real velocity at inlet. And this one is your same Vr1 is your relative velocity, and same this in case of Kaplan turbine. Here beta equal to 0, beta angle equal to 90 degree. So what happens? Vr2 is equal to Vf2, and Vw2 becomes here 0, and this total part is equal to u2, and this one is v2, and the notations and is already told in your Francis turbine. Thank you.